Hey, this is Paul from MobileTrans Wondershare, and welcome back to another video. And if you haven't heard, MobileTrans has now been updated to its version 3.5 software. So before we show you anything in today's video, make sure you update that. Once you've unboxed your brand new iPhone 13, sometimes making sure that you restore it to a previous backup can seem like a bit of a nightmare. But this video will show you exactly how to do it and show you how easy it is. And of course, if you haven't got your iPhone 13 yet, but are thinking of getting one, then the tips and tricks in this video will help you. So carry on watching so you know exactly what to do when you get that iPhone. But of course, before we get started, if you're new here to MobileTrans, then why not subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any of these videos that we post, because we have weekly videos that we put up here to help you guys with MobileTrans. And of course, let us know in the comments as well what you think about this video. And if you need any help with any other topics, then why not ask below. Apple recently unveiled its new iPhone lineup, including the standard iPhone 13, the 13 mini, the 13 Pro, and the 13 Pro Max. Now, if you're thinking of getting an iPhone 13, you need to make sure that your previous phone is ready so you can back that up and move all that data over to your brand new iPhone 13. And you might be sat there thinking that why today? Why are we talking about this topic today? But lots of people have the problem that when they get their new iPhone, they sometimes lose their data and they can't move it across from their old iPhone to a new iPhone. And when you get the iPhone 13, we want to make sure that that process of moving your data from one phone to another is nice and simple, and you don't lose any of your photos, your contacts, any of your videos, anything like that. So that is why we're talking about this today. And the best way to make sure you don't lose any of that data is to make sure that you back up your phone on a regular basis. And it's something that people forget all the time, but it's one of the most important things that you need to do, especially if you're going to be getting a new phone. So I think we should go straight into topic number one and show you exactly how you can do that. The first method is probably the most simple method, and that is to use iCloud. And when setting up your new iPhone, what you can do is actually restore the data from your old phone to your brand new iPhone 13. And it's nice and simple and doesn't take very long at all. So let me show you the steps that you would have to take to make sure that that works. You need to turn on your brand new iPhone 13 first of all, and go through the steps to set up your phone. And when you get to the apps and data screen, you will see a button that says restore from iCloud backup. Here, you need to sign in with your Apple ID and then pick the most recent backup of your old iPhone. After that, your phone will restore your settings and your preferences, and you'll be able to use it in around about 15 minutes. And then you can still use it as it is downloading all of those apps. And it's as easy as that. You've now restored everything to that new iPhone 13. It is simple, it's quick, and it is not very difficult to do. And when you're now downloading the rest of those apps, you can then still use your phone as you would have previously. But we should move on to another method, and that method is to show you how to use your computer. The first thing you need to do is open the Finder on a Mac running Mac Catalina 10.15 or later. When you're in the Finder window on Mac or iTunes, you'll be able to select your iPhone automatically. Then, using the USB cable, connect your iPhone to the computer, and then to proceed, you might need to enter your device's passcode or select Trust This Computer, and then we will show you what to do. The first step is to choose Restore Backup and then select a backup. So make sure it is the most recent backup that you're selecting so you don't lose any of that important data. Then you just need to wait for that restore to finish before clicking done. For encrypted backups, you might be prompted to enter a password. And if you don't know that password, that becomes quite difficult because you then cannot use that backup. Just make sure you keep your device connected and wait for it to sync with your computer after restarting. And then when the sync is complete, you can then disconnect. Then all you have to do is just give it a bit of time while it makes that restore to your new iPhone 13. And this can take a bit of time sometimes. So just make sure that you're nice and patient. And then that is it. Your iPhone would have been restored from that latest backup. But we are not finished there. We have another method for you to see, and that is to use MobileTrans version 3.5. Restoring data to your new iPhone 13 can be easier. All you need is Wondershare MobileTrans. It's a desktop application that assists over 500,000 people in transferring, backing up, and restoring data between phones. You might want to import data from your computer to the new phone when upgrading to that new phone, and MobileTrans makes everything easier for you. So this is how you do it. Firstly, you need to connect your phone to the PC, and then you need to click Restore on the MobileTrans homepage and choose the MobileTrans backup file. Now, preview your backup files and choose to restore, and then click Start. All you need to do now is wait and let MobileTrans restore all the data to your phone. There we go, there are three methods there to help you restore your backups on to your new iPhone 13. And my question to you is, how many times do you back up your phone? Let me know in the comments below, because a lot of people never back it up at all. Some people only back it up once a month, but really you should try and back up your phone every single day to make sure that you don't lose any of that really important data, because who knows when your phone might break and then you might have to get a new one. So always really important to make sure that you keep your phone backed up to its latest backup. If you enjoyed this video and it helped you out at all, why not share it with a friend to help them? Like it, subscribe to the channel, and of course, let us know in the comments below if you need any help with anything else. And of course, we will try to help you out. So I hope this video helped you, and if it did, we will see you in the next video.